Good morning, everyone. Good morning, ma'am. Group 1 had come up to discuss behaviorism. After a thorough discussion, the consolidated ideas and gathered data information has been analyzed and put into video presentation that has been recorded earlier. This time, I'll be sharing to you on how Group 1 understood behaviorism and with exploration of research as well. Behaviorism is a learning theory based on the idea that behavior can be controlled or modified based on the antecedents and consequences of a behavior. A behavior will only occur if given the right environment or antecedent. The behavior is more or less likely to reoccur based on the reinforcement or consequences that follow, such as rewards and punishments. Behaviorism is often used for shaping classroom behaviors and helping students learn basic facts and skills. The group members also were able to think a lot of examples on how to apply behaviorism in a classroom, since we are centered in learning-centered teaching. First is that you can watch TV as soon as you are done with your homework. Second, students who complete all the homeworks this week don't have to take the quiz on Friday. The third example is receiving a sticker for a correct answer on math problem. Students who arrive late will receive detention. These are just few examples of implementing or applying behaviorism in a classroom. Another one. Since we are future educators, we also come up with behaviorist teaching strategies. Teachers can implement behavioral learning strategies techniques in their classroom in many ways, including, first, the drills. Teachers may practice skills using drill patterns to help students see the repetition and reinforcement the behavioral learning theory uses. Question and answer. Teachers can use a question as a stimulus and answer a response, gradually getting harder with questions to help students. The third one is guided practice. Teachers can be directly involved in helping students go through problems to give them the reinforcement and behavior demonstration you want them to follow. Regular review. Reviews are important to behavioral learning theory. Going back over material and giving positive reinforcement will help students retain information much better. The next one is the positive reinforcement. Behaviorist classrooms utilize positive reinforcement regularly. This can be in the form of verbal reinforcement and praise reward systems, added privileges, and more. A common example of behaviorism is positive reinforcement. A student gets a small treat if they get 100% on their spelling test. In the future, students work hard and study for their tests in order to get the award. Last quote, behaviorism is key for educators because it impacts how students react and behave in the classroom, and suggests that teachers can directly influence how their students behave. That's it for the discussions from Group 1 regarding the behaviorism. I hope that you come up with ideas and thoughts as well with it. Thank you so much. God bless.